Many things. What does a medal represent to the country? If we can think about it, medal represents so many things to each one of us, to all 140 million Indians. So I would like to congratulate on behalf of Hyderabad City Police, Hyderabad City, PV Sindhu for so many things, not just a medal for the country. She deserves congratulation for uniting the entire country. There are very few occasions when from Kashmir to Kanyakumari, from Bhuj to Kamakhya, each and every person is glued to television with only one hope that yes, she wins. Irrespective of religion, irrespective of creed, caste, region, state, she brought the entire country to one feeling. So hearty congratulations for that. Hearty congratulations for bringing a smile on everyone's face. Whether a person is depressed, whether a person is sick, whether this person is in hospital, everyone smiled because of PV Sindhu. Hearty congratulations. Hearty congratulations for bringing even the rivals to the same. I remember in hostels and colleges, there are many groups, but they all watch the same thing and they greet together, they cheer up together. So even the rivals and the enemies, they came together. Hearty congratulations for that, Sindhu. And as far as nation building is concerned, I would say for showing a path of determination, dedication, hard work and discipline to the millions of new generation, which will be the future of India. So hearty congratulations for that. And as an Indian, I think you have given us one more reason to feel proud to be called Indian. Hearty congratulations for that.
Hey, Babu.
Kurchondi, Babu, Kurchondi. When some of us would be traveling abroad, you have given us an identity that yes, a country which has given a champion, Sindhu, in badminton. So this is a sense of identity to all of us. Hearty congratulations for that. We learn a lot from you, Sindhu. I want to share my feelings about how I see life in the wake of this great achievement by you. Right from our childhood, we get a lot of choices. We get a lot of choices. It is for us to select in what direction we are going. Sometimes role of parents, sometimes role of atmosphere, environment, sometimes our own zeal. But there is always a choice. And that choice is a continuous process. It is not that one day we did it and second day we did it, 1 week we did it, and after that we did not do it. No. It has to be a choice every day. And that is what makes the real metal of a person. And that is why I said that what you see a person here, PV Sindhu, is not a person of bone and flesh. She is a person which has nerve of steel. Then only you can come to this level. That nerve of steel is what is required in our country. The choice which she made, the choice which Ramana Garu made, that yes, how a child should grow, and continued, nurtured for such a long period, maintaining at the top level in the world for more than 6-7 years. It is beyond imagination, beyond imagination. So that choice, I would say that this is something which determines the nation, particularly the new generation, what choice we are making and how we are pursuing that choice. Every day we get a choice. Small thing, whether morning we are getting up and doing something which we want to do or not, or we are looking for some excuse not to do it. That is a great thing which we have learned from her. when perhaps she was young, I do not know much about her much younger days life, but I am sure when children of her age was eating pizza, coke, watching movie and having popcorn, at that time she must be working hard and toiling. That is what is the nerve of steel defined as. So 2020 Tokyo Olympic medalist, 2019 world champion, gold medal, first Indian to become world champion in badminton. 2017, she rose to a career high in the world, and maintaining such a form since then, since 2017 till 2021, to be at the top of the world, imagine how much tons of sweat she has taken out to come to this place. 5 years at the top of the world. At 2012, at the age of 17, she broke into the top 20 of the badminton league. And awarded with Major Dhyan Chand Khel Ratan Award, Padma Bhushan. Her rise to success and glory, I would say, inspires not just sports person. It inspires the entire nation in every field. Yes, sports will be the first thing to get the attraction. And that is what I was very optimistically telling to Anil Kumar, that next Olympic, because of such achievement, we will target for 50 medals. But when you get pride about yourself, when you get pride about your country, your atmosphere, environment, then that pride generates an atmosphere of excellence in every field. In every field. And that is what she has contributed. We all are absolutely indebted, the entire country is indebted to you, Sindhu, for bringing this marvelous achievement to the country. I will talk about the family. Born and brought up in Hyderabad to Sri P.V. Ramana and P. Vijaya Garu. Both parents were national level volleyball players. Father Ramana Garu. Father Ramana Garu was a member of the volleyball team that won bronze medal in Seoul Asian Games. He got Arjuna Award in 2000 and for his contribution to sports. And perhaps if I remember correctly, they are the first father and daughter combination to get Arjuna Award. No, please come. There was a time when she was traveling 56 kilometers daily to report to a coaching center. What a commitment and hard work. It shows the determination of father-daughter duo. Her former coach, Gopi Chand, once said that Sindhu has one uniqueness. She has a never-say-die approach under any circumstances. Never-say-die approach. This is what makes her different. There are some, you know, when a big personality, when a big achiever achieves something, a lot of people talk to her. And many things come out from within about what she feels about various things. So I would like to quote her, some of her quotes which defines what she is. She says, it is Sindhu's statement. Your dreams are what defines your individuality. Who you are is defined by your dreams. They have the power to give you wings and make you fly high. Dreaming is so important. I remember APJ Abdul Kalam also has spoken a lot about Igniting Mind book, that how the new generation should dream. That is the seed for everything. Then on another occasion, Sindhu says, I have learned many things, but there are more to learn. Every day is a new start. That hunger that yes, I have to do better. And every day is a new day. On other occasions, he says, there will be many obstacles in the pursuit of your dream, but you have to carry them. Yes, many obstacles. And we have a big obstacle, a big country, China, on our north, always there. So we have to always cross. Win or lose, I always focus only on giving my 100%. What can you give the best? You can give the best is 100% of what you have. Then you may win sometimes, you may lose sometimes. But from your side, it should be 100%, it should not be 99%. It's all she is saying. You win sometimes, you lose sometimes, it is all part of game. You all have to take it in a positive way. I think this is not just sports, this is life, what she has said. Another thing very important from her, particularly her kind of game. Injuries are part of life. We cannot decide on that. There is hardly any athlete, sports person on world who has not been injured. It is part of life. And if you expand this definition, it is part of everyone's life. Injury means it can be also taken as figuratively speaking, that there will always be time when you will be down. How you get up? On other occasions, Sindhu says, I have a lot of hunger to win the big titles. That hunger to win the big titles. On another occasion, I don't fear anyone. I just concentrate on giving my best. Yes, I will compare it because when we were in, I think, school, when first time India won the World Cup in cricket, we were underdogs. Nobody knew that we will beat the mighty West Indians. Clive Lloyd and Michael Holding and Andy Roberts, Vivian Richards, and Indian team won against them. No matter how big is the team, opponent, but never get overwhelmed. This is, she says. Another very important thing. A small cold or cough can actually stop you from going where you are. No matter how much hard work you do, no matter how much sweat you do, no matter how much best coach you have, but at the wrong time, if you get a small cough and cold, your performance will come down. These are all pearls of wisdom from the champion which we have here. Before I close my feelings about her, I would quote a Sanskrit shloka, which is found in one of the Upanishads. It says, Shaile shaile na manikyam, moktyam na gaje gaje. I will translate it also. Shaile shaile na manikyam, moktyam na gaje gaje, sadhvo nahi sarvatra, chandanam na vane vane. It means, all mountains do not have beads. All elephants do not have pearls in their forehead. Sadhus do not exist at all places. And sandalwood is not found in all forests. That is why P.V. Sindhu is not found in all countries. She is found in India. So, thank you so much.